Hello, everybody, and welcome to another evening of Nail Talk Live. And today we have a new topic, a different topic, of course, and it's all about short nails.
Short nails. I love short nails.
Yeah, I know. You always have short nails on your hands.
Yeah.
I also always have short nails on my hands, even though they look a little bit longer, but that's due to my hypernicium. Mm-hmm. But this short nail is really a big, big, big trend.
It is. It is. With minimalistic nail art sometimes, but really short.
Yeah. Even also with a tiny French manicure.
Yeah, that's really cool. Looks so awesome.
But it's like a new generation of clients.
Yeah.
And it also fits a new generation of nail technicians. In the past, we had a difference between the gel polish technician and, on the other hand, the nail technician that really elongates the natural nail, creates a nail. But this new type is more, it's a totally different target audience.
Yeah.
So it's important that you hear and see what this trend is all about, how you sell it, how you market it, and to who. So let's get started. And as you are used from us, we are joined by two of our trainers, and this time it's Linda and, of course, our own Wendy. Hello, girls.
Hello. Hi, everybody.
And we're going to share our opinions and our views on this natural nail, short nails. Wendy, do you see this trend already with your clients?
I have a lot of clients who likes to wear short nails. I also do myself love to wear short nails, but I like to make long nails. But yes, in the salon, I see it often, yeah.
Okay, and Linda, how's that? Is that the case with you?
In the salon, I only do short nails. I only have one client with longer nails. So I do it a lot.
And yes?
Yeah, also the same as Linda. Yeah. I have a few clients who wear really long. I have one who wears really long, but I think 90% wear short. Yeah.
And what is your definition of a short nail? What is the length of
really
the extension?
Short. Really short, as short as it can be.
So finger top, the tip of the finger.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Well,
I really love that. Yeah.
And do they want to wear it with color or French or nude?
Well, my clients wear color, but I really love the nude and the really softness. I really love that too. Yeah.
Yeah, because this new trend is the very short nail, so it's fingertip length, and it's done mostly in nude shades. Shades that complement the nail, and it's almost like an invisible nail, an invisible nail overlay.
Yeah.
And that's also the whole point of it. Perhaps Wendy, do you know what who's the target audience for this nail?
I think there are different kind of audience for it. The younger girls, but in my studio I see a lot of hard-working women who want to wear short nails. They have a busy life, children, so that is my audience.
Okay, yeah. And Lynn?
Actually, same as Wendy. And also the younger girls just for fashion, but also the older, the mothers.
Yeah. And I think, in my salon, the youngest clients wear them really square and short.
Yeah.
And as they came older, more rounded. Yeah. But short.
Yeah. Yeah, I also see this trend really as a thing for the younger generation clients, because the younger girls, they want to really treat themselves and present themselves as best as possible, but not visibly fake.
No.
So we have to approach nature and beautify nature, but it's really about presenting yourself. And it's not so much the girl that really has a personality in her nails, like different colors and gel polishes. It's really about all natural, but helped a little bit. Like, for instance, eyelash treatments, perhaps filler treatments here and there.
Yeah.
And then the nails as natural as possible, but as beautiful as possible.
Yeah.
And what is very important in this treatment is not only the nail itself, but the way the preparation is done, the manicure. Because the beautiful cuticle is what really sets this treatment apart. Silvana, this is one of your specialties. We also filmed with you a couple of demos. Can you tell us a little bit about your clients? Who are they and why do they want to have these nails?
Hi, everybody. Yeah, mostly I have younger girls. And like Wendy says, younger girls always have like square nails. And the older they get, the rounder they get. So I have mostly younger girls who has square nails.
Okay, so and you prepared a demo and we're going to have a look at that. A short nail, but with a color on top of it. Our favorite majestic blue, of
yeah.
course.
First, I put the cuticle back with a cuticle pusher. I think it's very important to do the prep like really perfect, so the gel polish application fits really perfect.
Yeah.
First, I'll take a prep bit.
So you do a combi manicure. It's
yeah.
both cutting and a little bit of cutting and using the e-file.
Yes, you're right. Now I'm lifting the proximal nail fold a little bit up so I can see where I can cut.
Yeah.
I use scissors to cut only the little dead skin that you see.
Yeah, and just a little bit, hey? Never overcutting.
No, we don't want any bleed.
And your client already has a short nail, of course, but she wants
yeah.
it even shorter, I believe.
Yeah, she wants it even shorter and she wants it square, so I will shape it later. Now I'm buffing the nail. The cuticle to have a lighter, a little bit of shine.
Yeah, and when you do this treatment in your salon, you work in phases. So in phase one, you first do the build up of the or the strengthening of the natural nail.
Yeah, so they can really grow, and then in phase two, I can put like make a shape.
Yeah, so in the first phase, the first treatment, you file the nail down. Shorten it and strengthen it.
Mm-hmm.
Then after about 3 weeks, they come back. You have a little bit more length, of course. And then you shape the nail in a better, more perfect shape.
Yeah, and in phase three, we go to the length that they want. But mostly they want it really short. And I prefer like to go max to 1 centimeter above the nail tip.
1 millimeter.
Yeah.
And you're using your favorite product. Can you tell us a little bit about
yes,
this?
Yes, it is the new rubber base. It's, I don't know the color exactly.
It's intense pink.
Yeah, it's intense pink. I flattened the brush so it can go really deep, go to the cuticle area.
Yeah.
And it's really a thin layer for the first layer.
And rubber base is so unique because it adheres perfectly. Yeah, the adhesion is super.
Yeah, and you have to not build a big thing. You can level like only little layers.
Yeah, so because you advise to use 3 layers, I believe.
Yeah, this is my second layer. It's the same thickened as the first one.
Yeah. So you don't need any soft bond primer underneath the rubber base because it adheres perfectly without,
yep.
I believe.
You don't need any primer or bond.
The Intense Pink was developed for people with beautiful colored natural nails that just need a little bit more pink to it. It's now cured and of course the shine is or the sticky layer is removed. And now you always advise to do a little bit of filing.
Yeah, so it will, like if you polish it, it will stay perfectly.
So you first make the middle line,
mm-hmm.
you're filing it, and then you go to around the cuticle.
Yeah.
You have to be careful with the rubber base that you don't overfile.
Yeah, otherwise you will file your levels down to 1 level again, and that's not what we want.
Yeah, it's just photoshopping the nail.
Yeah, exactly.
And this is the Majestic Blue, of course, a beautiful color, one of our
beautiful.
Favorites. And you go very close to the cuticle.
Yeah.
In your experience, do a lot of young girls wear very dramatic colors or do they prefer very soft, muted tones?
No, they prefer nuded colors or peach colors. Yeah, that's the most thing I do in the salon. Mostly the seduction shears.
Yeah, the semi-transparent colors. And then you apply those over the rubber base application.
Yeah. Just one layer, because it gives you a little bit of a glow.
Of course, you're using Jessica's Choice mm-hmm. to really perfect the smile line, of their smile line, the cuticle application.
Yeah. Yes. And I'm using the Supreme Finish Top Gel to give it a beautiful highlight, beautiful shine.
Do you advise to hold the Supreme Finish upside down when it's applied on the nail?
Yeah, so it can like level beautiful on the gel polish color.
Okay, it's a beautiful nail. It is very short.
Yeah, it is.
Back in the day when I started, I think that if I would apply this on my client, so she comes in for a new set and I would do this, I think they would think that I forgot the acrylic application. Yeah, yeah, it was really not done.
No, it's not.
Short. No. And also what I asked Silvana is, when you apply your top gel, because it's so short and so thin, before you go in the light, just hold it upside down for a couple of seconds. That helps the top gel to form the apex. That's of course a trick that we do also with our normal gels. Yeah. So what did you think, Linda, of this length nail, this particular shape, or do you recognize this?
Yeah, I love it. It's really beautiful, and especially the combination with the manicure and with the smoothing
the surface.
Yes, I love it, and also the color, the shortness. Yeah.
And Wendy, what is your opinion?
Yeah, I would love to wear them. I really like them. I like the shape, the length, and also the color.
Yeah, I also really adore it. I try mm-hmm. to get the square nails on my nails, but my hypernickia are too long, and then I have the corners here.
Yeah.
But it's very specific. What is also very specific are the names of our colors, of course. Majestic
yeah.
blue.
Yeah.
We were inspired by the gown that our queen wore to the inauguration of her husband, mm-hmm. the King of Holland. But we also have gel polish that are called Bitch in Bikini, is a name that stays with you forever, of course,
yeah.
because it's a great name.
Yeah.
And we have many names. But sometimes people ask us, how do you come on, how do you figure out those names? Where yeah. does the inspiration come from? And sometimes you really cannot predict what the name of a color will be. And I believe that, Silvana, that you have some videos about this issue.
Yes, I have. When I see a gel polish color, it gives me always a feeling or a vibe. And I have two men, and they are guessing the name of a nail polish color. Let's see.
Yeah, I'm curious.
Between the clouds.
So
day.
This is called Between the Clouds.
Bikini,
and he said Damper
so
Day.
Teeny.
Well.
Convertible Fun.
Sonic Boom.
Sonic
Convertible
boom.
Fun.
Men are always that
funeral
creative
ashes.
And
funeral ashes.
Cashmere bathrobe. Baby Flamingo.
Well, that's a cute Sweet. Name, Baby
yeah,
Flamingo.
Yeah, that's a cute name.
Adorable. Sweet 16.
Sweet 16. Menstrual monotony.
Menstrual
monotony. Okie dokie.
Okay.
Salmon time. First lady.
Salmon time. Yeah. I love a piece of salmon.
Princess rule. Oh, hey. Okay. I went the right direction. Yeah.
That was it. And my question for you is, what are your favorite gel polish names?
Well, Silvana, I wasn't prepared for that question,
no.
So let's pass it to the trainers.
Good
and
idea.
They can
Good idea.
Answer it first.
Well, for me, it's not my favorite name, but it was a funky name because the name was Funky Fuchsia, but the color was actually orange. So that was a little bit strange, so I remember that name.
Yeah, and I like the name Bitchy Bikini, but I also love the names of the new neon colors we have. They have cocktail names like Mimosa, Cosmopolitan, Apple Martini,
Bloody Mary.
I love that names.
Yeah, and Jessica, do you know?
Well, the same as Wendy. I really, really am in love with those names. But I always wondered, the color is not in our assortment anymore. The Kopi Luwak, that was
yeah.
a name that you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Kopi Luwak.
Yeah.
It's a very expensive type of coffee.
Yeah.
made from, well, yeah, let's not yeah. get into that.
Monkeys and stuff, but yeah, mm-hmm, yeah. yeah.
Monkeys? No, yeah. not monkeys.
No other animals.
No, it, the cat. The yeah. civet cat eats the eats
they
the
look like
coffee
monkeys.
Ground.
Yeah,
and
but
et
anywho, I really love that name.
Okay, yeah, I like it too. Before I tell you my favorite, first Sylvana, what's your favorite name?
My favorite name is Rudolph's Glitternose.
Oh yeah, yeah,
that
was fun
yeah. as well.
We have so many yeah. different names.
My favorite name is Indecent Ivory because it's just a great name. It's an older shade.
Yeah,
but if you like that ivory
white.
Look.
The Schnee White.
The Schnee White.
The Schnee
also
White.
Nice. Well,
yeah.
we can continue yeah. and continue and continue.
Yeah, we can.
But
yeah.
naming our gel polish is, of course, a fun thing to do.
Do you do that with or without alcohol? Just asking.
Both.
Okay.
So I actually should have one gel polish called Chardonnay.
Yeah.
That's typical of us. Anyhow, we go to a next nail, and this is also done by Sylvana, but it's a short version of a French manicure nail. So again, Sylvana is pushing back the cuticle because this remains very important. This nail is already quite short. The natural nail is not perfect. There's a little bit leftover color. She was polishing her nails with nail polish. And Sylvana is going to remove that, of course, during this application. Again, filing the nail. And as you can see, she barely files the lower arch to maintain the integrity of the nail and to maintain the strength of the natural nail. And then filing away the corner just a tiny bit, otherwise you can scratch yourself with this shape. Using the silky smooth brush, she's removing the dust, and now she's filing the surface of the nail with a 220 grit file. Just making sure that the whole nail, and she's left-handed, that's why she starts on the other side. Again, doing an e-manicure, using the prep bit, pushing back the cuticle a little bit further and loosening the skin. And this is still very important, as we mentioned, but it's also quite fast. It's not a real delay. And what is also fun and typical of this new target audience is that they expect to pay more for this treatment, because a higher price means a more exclusive service. So if somebody is willing to pay 80, 90 euros for a brow treatment, well, you can imagine that they are also willing to pay 60 to 70, 80 euros for this specific treatment, so you really have to make it as perfect as possible. After cutting the cuticle, of course, again buffing the surface, you can also use this buffing bit to buff in the cuticle oil into the natural nail and in the cuticle after the surface is done. And that gives really a beautiful sheen
That's
to the
natural nail.
That's a great
idea. Yeah.
Yeah.
yeah,
I can believe
you should
that, yeah.
definitely try it.
Yeah.
The color that she's using now is the Cool Cover Rubber Base, which is a very almost, yeah, it's of course an extension color, an extender color, but it's a very nice pink tone. We also have a warm cover base.
So for every skin color, there's a different type of,
rubber base.
Rubber
yeah.
base, yeah.
Yeah, we have warm cover, cool cover, frosted pink, which is semi-translucent, and of course the intense pink for the people that already have beautiful natural nails. This nail is also built up in different levels, and these levels gives you the strength and also the body of the nail. Make sure that you have also examples of these nails if you want to promote yourself. And what is very important with these nails, but with nails in general, is the daily use of cuticle oil, twice a day to maintain the beauty of the skin surrounding the nail unit. Softly smoothing out the surface and then taking liner gel white with, I think, Jessica's Choice. Yeah, Jessica's Choice brush, of course. She's really painting the thinnest French manicure I've ever saw.
Yeah, and I see this in different kind of colors.
Yeah.
The French.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With our new...
It's really a trend now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It takes me a little bit back
really
in time.
Cool.
Yeah.
Hmm?
Well, the shape of the smile line takes us back in time,
yeah.
but the length, it is really a beautiful nail for if you want a really natural look.
Yeah.
but still want to show that you take care of yourself. It's not so natural that you think there's no nail.
It's also a beautiful bridal nail.
Yeah. Yeah, well, for bridal nails, I would prefer stilettos with flowers.
Yeah, me as well, but I definitely, yeah. I also see a bridal nail on this.
Finishing the nail with Supreme Finish. And the nice thing with this nail is that you see that it really, it's not longer than the tip of the finger. But it is a well-polished, well-mannered look.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah, a huge trend.
Yeah.
You see this a lot on Facebook, on Instagram, mainly on Instagram, because the target audience is also more active on Instagram than they are on Facebook.
Great job, Savannah.
Thank you.
Well, for a bride, we will go long, but for bridesmaids, that will be really cool. The short French.
Oh, yeah. That's
for the bridesmaids. That's
yeah. Okay, I agree with that.
Yeah, that will be fun. Yeah.
Yeah. Ha ha. So, really cool design. Perhaps you are wondering to yourself, I have my clients already, and my clients, they are wearing artificial nails, let's say power gel nails, but I want to start doing this as well, because chances are that your clients will see that these nails are very gaining popularity. Mm-hmm. Of course, you can do this also during a fill. And Miriam is going to show us how she does this. Miriam Zwart is our distributor from Almere here in Holland. She already filed down the product. So the natural nail, all the product is already filed down. And now she's applying the product on the natural nail. She's first using base and top, but you could also use rubber base to promote adhesion.
Smart.
Now she's gently pushing back the cuticle. Be careful not to touch the surface of the nail. Not to touch the sticky residue on the nail. And she chose to work with fiber coats. Fiber coats are a little bit more flexible than rubber base. So they have a different wear. Some people like to wear really soft and flexible nails. Other people like to wear the harder nails. And it depends on A, the natural nail, but also on what you want to feel.
And what is the difference in viscosity between rubber base and fiber coat?
Fiber coat is a little bit thicker. That's also due to the fiber particles that are in there, while rubber base is like in between building base and a fiber coat.
Okay.
Can you also build with the building rubber base?
Yes, you can extend the nail a little bit.
Okay.
Let's say up to 3 millimeters.
And is it self-leveling as the fiber coat?
Yes, it's a little bit faster self-leveling. Mm-hmm. Fiber coat needs a little bit more help.
Okay.
Removing the sticky layer, of course, being careful not to push in the sticky layer into the skin. And Miriam is using Pepin. She chose a longer brush, but with liner gel white, mixed with a little bit of Charissa Sweetie's white coconut. And you see here, this is a typical nail technician. So Miriam is a real nail technician. Mm-hmm. So she already makes it a little bit longer, the French, and a little bit deeper. So this is, I think, more what we think of when we think of a short French manicure nail. It's a beautiful nail.
I think my clients, the ages, like my age, we prefer this French, but the younger girls, what Sylvana showed us.
Yeah, I think that you're right. But this is more an artificial nail.
Yeah. I like both.
Yeah.
Also your toenails.
I think only nail technicians understand there is a huge difference between the first short French manicure and the second short French manicure. But I think our husbands will think that we're totally strange. Yeah.
They wouldn't see it.
They wouldn't see it. Sylvana, what did you think of this version of the short French?
I think it's really nice. It's for the older woman, what you said. I think they like it a little bit more than the younger girls, but they're both perfectly.
So now we are the older woman.
Well, get used to it and accept it, Linda. We are the older a generation nail technicians.
Except me, I'm still 18.
Life begins now.
So, a big difference between these two, but both short French manicure nails. And look at your own country, your own region. What is the trend? Where is it developing to? This really came all of a sudden, and I'm convinced that we will see more and more of this. Silvana, you have also some social media items.
Yes, I have. I was looking through Instagram and I found shorties from all over the world. Let's see. Our first one are from Scotland. Pink shorties, also rounded. Next one, from Israel.
Cool. I love it.
Also thin beautiful. French. Majestic blue from France.
So cool.
Yeah. Also in matte.
Yeah, matte version is really nice.
Yeah.
And we have from Italy.
Yeah. That's cute.
Yeah.
No, Amy.
Really pretty.
That's a trend as well, with the different colors.
Yeah.
Yeah. Really
it
love
is.
That.
Mm-hmm.
Last but not least, those are mine.
Oh.
Great. Beautiful.
Beautiful.
It's a really popular color with me in the salon. It's bathing in the sun. And these were my socials for today. I'll see you next week.
Bathing in the sun is also a great gel polish name, of course,
mm-hmm.
because some people love to bathe in the sun. And it's from our spring collection.
Yeah, the spring. Yeah.
Spring collection.
Yeah.
We also try with the names of our gel polish to give you a mood and to give you a sense of emotion, mm-hmm. feeling. And that was something I spoke with Silvana recently, and she came with a great idea. And I have to share that with you and also with you. Just imagine that you have two different green colors. And you have, for instance, the Mind Your Mint. And on the other hand, we have feet on the grass. Feeling the grass.
Feeling
the grass, sorry. And you have a client and she's not able to choose between these two. How would you handle that?
Yeah, I don't have an answer for that.
No, I also always had a difficulty with that. Linda?
Yeah.
She can't pick, but make a decision between those two colors. That's the question, right?
Yeah.
I would just look at her skin and give her the advice.
Okay. Well, that's also how I would have handled it.
Yeah.
So how would you handle it?
The same. Yeah.
Well, you know how Silvana handles this. She asks her client, what is your current mood? Are you in the mood for a festival, going outside, feeling the ground under your feet and having a picnic? Then you have to do feel the grass or feeling the grass. But is your mood going and make selfies outside on the terrace having a glass of wine with your girlfriend? Well, then your mood is really Mind Your Mint. And that works always, doesn't it, Silvana?
Yes, you said it perfectly. It always works.
Okay.
So start thinking about that. That's why we name our colors how we name them. For instance, are you more a cosmopolitan girl? Or are you more a Bloody Mary girl? And not only the color, but the whole mood. I really found that a great idea. So, think of that.
Yeah.
It's
last
really
but not
a great
least,
idea.
We have some nail art. And that's done by you, Linda.
Yes.
And what is it?
Krullen.
Curls, okay.
Curls.
Beautiful ornamental curls.
Yes.
Okay, let's have a look. So we have here the nail.
Yeah, I built it with acrylics with camouflage cool pink, and I finished it with the Magnolia gel polish.
Yeah.
And now I'm making the curls with the rhinestone nail art brush.
Oh, that's your favorite, huh?
Yes, for the curls it is, because it's natural hair.
Yeah.
And it swings.
And it's also the mixture that
yes,
you use?
Yes, yes.
Sweetie's white coconut and liner gel white.
Yes. And it's a really small curl, a little ornament, not too much. And also for a bridal nail, I think it's beautiful.
When we used to work in the salon, we did this like on a daily basis.
Like 10 times a day.
Yeah, but it is always popular in every color, with a rhinestone, without a rhinestone.
It stays popular. And you can make it as big or as small as you like?
Of course.
Of course, a rhinestone.
Of course.
Yeah, a nail done by Linda without a rhinestone is like impossible.
Yeah, almost.
Beautiful, Lynn.
Thank you.
And then finishing it with supreme finish?
Yes, with supreme finish.
And do you cap your rhinestones also with a supreme finish?
No, because you lose the shine of the rhinestone.
Oh, okay, smart tip. And if you hit for by accident the rhinestone, you can use the polish corrector to clean it.
Yeah, or maybe just a nail wipe, just wipe it a little bit off.
Really beautiful.
And very simple. I think this also fits that trend.
Yeah.
If it should be a little bit shorter.
Yeah, and a little smaller curl, I think.
Super cool.
Yeah, nice.
And then you can see a minimalistic approach to quite an ornamental design.
Yeah.
And the color underneath is beautiful.
Yeah, I love this color. Really. Yeah.
What was it again?
Magnolia.
Gel polish magnolia.
Yeah.
In combination with full cover. A beautiful nail.
Yeah.
Well, that was our show for tonight. We're going to extremes. Tonight we did short nails, super short nails. We talked about inspiration for names and how you can use it in your salon. Next week it's all about extreme nails. We go longer than long. We put everything on it that there is. Extreme nail art, extreme.
Love
so really
it.
For the nail technicians. Thank you for being
thank
here
you
today.
Girls. Thank you.
And thank you for watching and see you next week with the extreme nails. Bye.
Bye.